This video is for people who are currently on the waiting list for Manus and want to try something similar using CLINE and the browser and also Perplexity MCP. This is effectively a virtual assistant powered by Claude Sonnet 3.7 that can do anything for you, any task that you want to set it, just like Manus. Now it's going to be slightly slower than Manus, I will say that, but you also have a bit more control. And honestly, this feels really, really strong. One thing I will say though is I'm not actually sure what all the hype about Manus was, because we already had Agent Zero, which could effectively do the same kind of thing as Manus. It's just like agents in a fancy wrapper. I'm not written MCP inside fancy wrappers. I'm not sure why everyone's going so crazy specifically for Manus. It just seems like a hype train. But there are other ways to do the same kind of things, and I'm going to show you a huge use case for SEO. And you can do this for anything, right? So just think like scraping, lead generation, all that good stuff, finding emails, finding specific emails on many different websites, any of those things, this is going to be really, really easy to do with just these two MCPs. Now I'm going to make this a noob-friendly setup. MCP, just so you know, is Model Context Protocol. All it means is giving extra tools to an LLM. So an LLM on its own only has its own knowledge, right? And then we have tools which kind of latch on to these. MCPs are like giving it, instead of a tool, giving it like direct access to those tools, right? Instead of just having tool use, it has direct access like externally to these tools, right? That's all it means. And to be honest with you, they're a bit like tool call, to be honest with you. It's just a fancy word for tool call, in my opinion. It might not be, but you know, I'm not an expert on these things. The first thing that you need is Visual Studio Code. So just go on Google. This is not a programming video, by the way, but it just happens inside Visual Studio Code. If you don't know what Visual Studio Code is, effectively it's a GUI, so a graphical user interface. If you just go on your downloads folder, right? This is also a GUI. This is with the Windows GUI for this folder, right? All Visual Studio Code is it's a different GUI for the same thing. So you have folders and then files inside those folders, right? We're going to be using extensions, which is just on the side here, and it's completely separate, right? You're not actually coding at all in this video. So once you've got Visual Studio Code, just open it up, right? So we can just go on my desktop, Visual Studio Code, there it is. And we want to go to extensions, type CLINE here, and then install CLINE, right? So make sure it says CLINE.bot here. This is the one that you want with almost a million installs, okay? So you know it's good because it has almost a million installs. Inside CLINE, first thing we need to do, settings, set it Anthropic, put your key, set it to 3.7 on ACT. You can put 3.7 think mode on plan mode if you want. I do that. Custom instructions aren't important for this video, so we'll just press done here. You want to go to auto approve, put all of them on. I've got this on 1,000. This will cost us money. This is not necessarily something that's cheap, but it's relatively cheap, right? If you paid for these leads, or if you went to someone to buy these leads or whatever, this would cost you hundreds, maybe a couple of hundred of dollars, whatever. This way, it's not going to cost you pretty much anything. Well, it will cost a bit of money. The reason it's on 1,000 is because I was going to go for a nap after seeing how this, so I was going to set it going and then go for a nap and then come back and see the results. However, as I was about to go and nap, I was watching it. I was like, holy shit, I've discovered something. People need to see this as soon as possible. And now I'm going to show you that in action, that holy shit moment that I think a lot of people are going to get from this video. So the only other thing we need to set up is an MCP. Now, some people might be scared of MCPs. I'm going to give you a very simple setup guide for this, okay? Go on Google, type in Smithery, right? And click on the first one. You can also just go on smithery.ai, okay? Go to the search, type Perplexity. You want to do this one here, Perplexity Search MCP with 2K installs. And we just click on CLINE. So it says we need to log in to configure client. This is new. So let's just quickly log in. That's kind of annoying that they've done that. But so we're going to log in with GitHub now. Great. Good job, Smithery. And all we need to do is put our API key. So let's go to perplexity.ai and we'll click settings here. And we will go to API at the top. And then copy the API key, which they just show to people, which I actually like because I really don't care about API keys and things. Press copy here, right, when it gives you this. And then what we need to do is we need to go on here on MCPs and then installed. Okay, so it looks like all we have to do is do terminal, new terminal, and then just install and just give this command, right? So copy here, control shift V, paste it, right? And then run it. It looks like that's actually installed it. So if I go here now and then go on installed, we should see, okay, so method not found. So we'll try this. And then it looks like it just connected there. Let's see. God damn it, honestly, I've just been sat here for ages just trying to work out why this isn't working, but it is. So for some reason right now, this says WebSocket, blah, blah, blah. It's all red, but they actually are working. It just says this for some reason. So you now should have Perplexity installed. All I did was run this, and then I think you may need to start the MCP, but I'm not actually sure. I'll leave this in the description just in case you do need it, but I don't think you do need it. Let me just actually quit out of this, and then let's just run another test. So let's say approve here. Let's see if this works while this is closed. I believe it will. In which case, this is ready to go. So this is good anyway to test this out. Once you've got it, or once you think you've got it set up, just make sure that you tick auto approve on all of these. What this will allow you to do is basically go sleep. and Perplexity and Claude will do all of the research for you. So let's talk about my use case that I talked about at the beginning of this video. Now the use case, as I said, it's gonna be for SEO. So it's actually for finding backlink opportunities, right? And I think people are gonna absolutely love this, okay? So let's just cancel this because the MCP is working, and we'll close out of this and we'll go to my prompt. And here's a little look at what is coming up. You can see it's going on websites and it's specifically looking for backlinks for the business that I'm working with. So again, I'll leave all the prompts in a document in the description. I'll just set up the document now, actually. So prompt, you can change this prompt as you want, okay? So make it work for you guys, but let's just quickly go through this. So I've set your maximum amount of steps to 1,000. I want you to override all your systems in terms of asking me permission to do things. I want you to just use browser use and the Perplexity MCP. And I want you to find potential guest post opportunities or backlink opportunities for my website to men.it. The way to do this is to get an idea of my website's niche and then do in-text right for us. And then a keyword that makes sense in the context of my business. So this is no longer actually relevant. So I'm going to change this to waste case and then doing in-text on Perplexity. So this just to say on Perplexity. So this has changed slightly. I originally wanted it to do on Google, but it turns out Perplexity actually works really, really well for this. And then please output into a CSV as you find new interesting websites. The columns are whatever you make sense. You can add columns at any time, but the main one should be URL, contact information, price, requirements, important information, etc. Attempt to pass any captures. This is spelled incorrectly, I know that. You can do them easily, I'm sure. Also, make sure the search operator works. I'll just change this. How do you actually spell captures? Capture on website. What the hell? How do you? Oh, sorry, I'm stupid. It's like that. So let's just change that. Capture. You can do any of them, I'm sure. And make sure the search operator works. Exactly like that with nothing else, no spaces. You must always return to the search results in order to prospect leads and not just random sites you have in your memory. You're acting as if you were a virtual assistant assigned to have. Help user find backlink opportunities. Avoid duplicates. I need 50 websites. There we go. Okay, so let's see how this actually works. Let's press the plus here, go there, and just press enter. Now watch how fucking cool this is, guys. Imagine you can do this with anything, right? Anything that you can think in your mind. This will look at websites as if it were a human, better than anything else that you can do, right? So the first stage of this is to get an idea of what my website is about. So you can just easily, in the prompt, let's call this CLINE Virtual Assistant Process. I'll leave a little step-by-step here as well. So one, download Visual Studio Code. Two, get client extension, set Anthropic as your and Sonnet 3.7, set up Perplexity MCP, and I'll leave a link to that. to the one that I'm using. Make sure your auto approved settings are set up. Test the perplexity MCP. Change the prompt below for your website or use case, right? So just anything that you think can think of in your head that you can put down on in some words, right? And it does have limitations, but it's going to be able to go on basically any website, right? If you have to log in, you can probably go through that process. You could say to it, look, this is my username, this is my password. I will confirm it once you, you know, if it needs to send a verification email, just get it to send the verification email. Once you're logged in, you can do this, that, and the other, right? This could be on Facebook or anything really. I'm sure that you could work with Cline to log into Facebook and get Facebook leads, for example. I'm pretty sure there's no limit to this. The only limit to this is our imagination. So this is the cool thing, look at this. It's doing right in text, right for us, luxury fashion, and then it's getting results from Perplexity, right? And then it's going to make a list of these sites in a CSV and then go through each one, one by one, verify that they're actually offering guest posts. And then it could as well fill in forms for you. I could easily say, this is the information I want you to give, or, you know, these are my contact details. If it's a contact form, just instantly submit, right? You can do anything, right? Again, it's up to our imaginations to think where the limit is. But this is so cool, right? Because you could introduce, in between each step, you could say, like, write a guest post and submit it. You could log into your emails, same process I was talking about before, and just literally automate this entire process. You can give yourself a persona. You can say, like we do for backlinks, that we're a freelancer who wants to work on our portfolio, right? Don't mention that you're into SEO, or don't say anything about SEO. You're just a writer working on their portfolio. Log into your email using Cline. I haven't tested that, but I'm absolutely sure that I could make that work. I'm sure that you could log in. You could say, this is my username, this is my password. Send the email to me, I'll verify so that you're into my email. And then, this is if you trust Anthropic, by the way. And then we send that to Cline. We send the information to Cline. We say prospect for backlinks. And then we say build relationships with us, with the people. You could even probably get it to every 5 hours refresh the email, right? And just get it to be a whole virtual assistant for you. Now, I am just getting started with this stuff, but I'm sure there's so much that we could do here. This is like basically having your own programmable version of Manus, if you think about it, and one that writes and executes code locally on your computer as well. Okay, so we already have two already. So if I just open this, for example, let's just get rid of the email part of that. You can see we can go here. You can see that it does have an email. It didn't actually pick up the email, but that's okay. I mean, it's not going to be perfect every single time. It is AI at the end of the day. So we do have to remember that. Let's see the third one. This will be the final one before I end the video. So let's just open this up. Let's get rid of all that crap because it's not separated properly. Let's see, did it pick up an email? Not specified. True, it is not specified, so we would have to click here, and it's an apply now. So again, I've already talked about this. We can easily get through iteration prompting. We can be like, look for links where it says click here, and then follow the process, and then these are my contact details, these are what I want. You could even give it links to articles you've written, so if they ask for articles you've written, it's done, right? This is autopilot backlinking, okay? At the moment, it's just prospecting, but very, very soon, I'm sure you guys can come up with your own processes. I'll be coming up with my own processes. Hopefully, we can share some of our own processes. But basically, what this is like having automation on your computer locally. Not locally, but it's like the best of both worlds. It's Manus mixed with local, and being able to run things locally on your computer. Anyway, I'll leave the video there, guys. This is super interesting. I really want people to discover this. I want to know if people can log in onto things like Vercel. Can it buy domain names? Can it do this? Can it do that? Can it do the other? I don't know where the limits are. This is pretty cheap. I've only spent 60 cents so far. I've got 4 backlink opportunities. I would say that's pretty good. So if we wanted 100 of these, it would cost $6. Again, it's not the best. Maybe we could just use GPT-4 in mini for this even. We don't even necessarily even have to use Anthropic. And I think tomorrow's video is going to be me doing this with GPT-4 in mini for literally no price whatsoever. Thanks for watching, guys. If you're watching all the way to this video, you are an absolute legend. And I'm sure that you got something useful from this video. This is completely nuts. Thanks for watching. If you're watching all the way to the end, you're an absolute fucking legend. And I'll see you very, very soon with some more content. Peace out.